It's been a pretty active day all around us, to the north of us and to the south of us. We are right in the middle of all the action. You can see all the snow reports to the north of the area in the upper Great Lakes. They've got winter storm warnings, 4 to 6 inches of snow, even high wind warnings to the south of us. These are reports of hail, even a tornado warning in Kentucky this hour. It looks like it has just expired. That orange is a severe thunderstorm warning. This is all due to a cold front that is moving over the area at this hour, and it is producing all that snow to the north with the very cold air. And then we've got the stormy activity with all the milder temperatures, with all that moisture and that south wind coming from the south. And that's why we've got a clash there of the warm and cold air, and that cold front's going to be ushering in here, and we'll be seeing that cold as early as tomorrow morning. Right now, not looking too bad for us. We do have the showers, even a couple rumbles of thunder possible for Indianapolis as that tracks off to the northeast. We are looking pretty good, just some light scattered showers out there, but things will begin to change as far as our temperatures. We are at our warmest right now with temperatures in the mid 50s, so pretty unusual. That was due to a warm front, but now that cold front is beginning to move through as far as that cooler air filtering in. So already in the 40s here in the northwest corner of the viewing area, still in the mid to the upper 50s for everybody else, but this will begin to change, and you will see that hard divide here. 38 degrees there in parts of Ishwal, Chicago, and stretching back, we're in the 40s, but all that cold Arctic air is going to begin to pour in here. Look at this, even in the 60s to the south of the area there. So we did have a wide range of temperatures, very mild, but that's all going to begin to shift and change as that colder air begins to pour in here. Some windy conditions out there too, and we will have another windy day for our Monday. So we are talking about some wind chills as well. A much different day tomorrow. We'll see some sunshine, but it will be very cold and blustery. In fact, 7 a.m. it will be dry as you head out the door. We'll see a few peaks of sunshine. We'll see clearing throughout the day, but take a look at these numbers and take a look at the winds. We will have the winds shifting, and they will be out of the west northwest as we get into the afternoon, but you can see the temperatures falling into the low 30s, even 29 degrees. The winds will be gusting up to 25 miles an hour. So much different Monday. It's going to stay cold for the next couple of days. And this pretty much tells the story. We've got all that snow to the north. We've got the showers and the thunderstorms to the south. We're kind of right in the middle, but we did get some shower activity out there for this afternoon and some breezy conditions too. For tomorrow, you can see temperatures are going to be falling. We'll be down into the low 30s by the afternoon. And don't forget about those wind chills. Look what it's going to feel like as we get into tomorrow evening, 10 o'clock. It's going to feel like down to 11 degrees, 12 degrees. So bring those pets inside. Make sure the animals are out of the cold and the wind. Keep them warm as well. Look at this for Tuesday morning. Another very cold day. It's going to feel like it is only in the teens and the 20s for Tuesday as well. So you'll need to bundle up for the next couple of days. And as we take a look at the 7-day forecast, you can see we will have a gradual warm up. 30